angular momentum and angular velocity. So relationship between the angular momentum and angular velocity. For this, we consider one rigid body. This rigid body is rotating about the fixed point. Is rotating about the fixed point. Fixed axis. Okay, it is rotating about the fixed axis. Right? So in this we consider one of the point mass. The point mass is M, is having distance, that is the position of the point mass, that is r vector from the axis of rotation. So here this body will execute a circular motion about the fixed axis. It is executing a circular motion about the fixed axis. Here it is executing a circular motion means at any instant, if the point mass there is having this linear momentum, that linear momentum p vector is perpendicular to the position. At any instant, the linear momentum is tangential to the circular path. At any instant, you can take the momentum, the linear momentum is tangential to the circular path. Its tangential to the circular path means we can calculate the angle between r vector and p vector. That is not a vector theta. So the theta is the angle between r vector and p vector. That is also equal to 90 degree. At any instant, it is the momentum, linear momentum is perpendicular to the position r vector. So we can write that is theta is equal to 90 degree. So there is executed, it is in a circular motion, there is executed a momentum, that is not the angular momentum. The angular momentum is not a vector L. It can be calculated by using the formula of r into p sin theta. So L is equal to r into p, means that is a linear momentum. The linear momentum p vector is equal to m into v. So we can write that is mv sin theta is equal to 90 degree. So we can write mv sin 90 degree. So L is equal to r mv sin 90 degree is equal to 1. So the angular momentum L is equal to r into m into v. Here the r is a position. Okay, that is a perpendicular distance. M is a mass of the point mass. V is a velocity of the point mass. So we are going to discuss the angular momentum, relationship between the angular momentum and the angular velocity. So here this is a linear velocity. V is a linear velocity. Already we know that the relationship between the linear velocity and angular velocity, that is V is equal to r omega. It is a relationship between the linear velocity and angular velocity. Already you studied in 10th standard. Okay. So that equation is substituted in this equation means when it is executed a circular motion, we can write r m, what is the values of V? V is equal to r omega. So from this we can write what is the values of L? L is equal to m into r into r, r square into omega. So L is equal to m into r square into omega. Here the m is a mass of the point mass. So suppose you are calculating this rigid body, it is made up of the large number of point masses. So the total angular momentum of the rigid body means the angular momentum of the rigid body, it can be calculated by using the formula of L vector is equal to summation m r square omega vector. So the omega is angular velocity, it is a vector quantity. So we can write L vector is equal to summation mi r square. It is made up of the large number of particle, large number of point mass. So we can write L vector is equal to summation mi r square into omega vector. So from this we can write L vector is equal to What is the values of summation m i r i square? That is I. Moment of inertia. I is equal to m r square. So we can write I into omega vector. So this is the relation between the angular momentum and the angular velocity. Here the omega is the angular velocity. We know that. Okay. So this is the relation between the angular momentum and the angular velocity.